Hello and welcome back. I am Arumba. Thank you for joining me. We're playing some Europa Universalis IV. This is Ideas Guy 2.0. And we're beating up on the Ottoman because we can. Because we can. Buildings-wise, we could build buildings. If I could build any buildings, it would be what? I don't know. 0.13 on a temple seems okay. 0.16 is decent. 0.13 is okay. Take a 0.1. Temples are okay. They're just okay. They're pretty damn good, actually. They're one of the best in most cases, but we're also at a stage in the game where they're kind of starting to lose some of their edge over the other building types. Okay, one more quick pass on these. We'll do a 0.10 workshop, sure. Of course, that's coastline. Does it have a shipyard yet? It does. All right. If you already have a shipyard, then you can have a thing. Pretty sure we've already taken the time to build up naval force limit recently, so I'm not going to worry about that. We've got 0.12. Did I check temples in this region? I did. Very unlikely we're going to find good numbers up in this region. It's a cost. Cost is not going to be good. All right, shipyards. We have shipyards everywhere. If we were in my land, yes. I did do some development between episodes, so if there's any way that we can increase it, I would like to do that. We're almost to the point where we can integrate what's-his-face, so we'll be able to build more shipyards in his land. We could just queue the shipyards in his land now. Let's do that. That's probably going to be more valuable to me, I think, than temples. We'll just spend all of our money on that. We're going to go back to Mr. Autoderp. We're going to see how he's feeling about the war. Negative 30 reasons for peace. Probably going to have to wait until my army can get down there and occupy the capital again, but with 6 siege pips, 10 cannons, it should fall very quickly. And in the meantime, we're just waiting on some other forts to fall somewhere. Or maybe more rebels to fire? Or maybe for the Ottomans to engage my army when I wasn't expecting it? Alright, so 50% infantry combat ability, please. Nice 12 minus 2 is 10 versus 8 in the first fire phase. Come here, my pretties. Oh, that's lovely. Let's unappoint this leader from that army. Put him... actually, what kind of leader do we have here? We've got a 6-5-5-6. Okay, it's probably fine. Okay, so you don't really need to be there for now. You guys can lead, like, this guy to help forward these troops into this battle. We're just throwing another couple infantry into this. We're already locked. Our troops are holding out valiantly. 549 remain, and we've only lost... could have been better. It looks like we didn't roll the best. Still, there's only so much you can do, and I've got plenty of infantry to rally into this. Here comes another 16. Great thing about a pure infantry army is that you don't have to worry about your cannons getting put into the front row after the infantry fall. We'll just have infantry that line up behind them, and then eventually they take the front line, and whatever. Whereas his frontline infantry are going to die, and then his cannons will move forward. We'll kill some of them, and it's fine. Alright, this is a level 1 fort. We will head down to there with both armies for now, just to clear it out. Except we'll send one infantry to here. We have reinforcements arriving in one day. And I don't care how many troops you throw at this dude. We've got freaking Viktor Jankowski infantry here, okay? We've taken a lot of damage, but... Gain mercantilism at the cost of 1,000 ducats. I would do that, yes. I don't have any money right now, though. Could you wait a few months? Well, fortunately, the buildings that I just started are definitely less than 10% complete, so... Definitely less than 10% complete, right? Damn. They're not. Okay. I guess we could take out a loan. It's not a big deal. Also, I do want to demand diplomatic support from these guys soon. Alright, fine. If I had a button to convert money into mercantilism, I'd be doing it. So we'll take out the loan. Alright, Ottomans, we're back to 37%, man. Come on, negative 10 reasons? You know you don't want to be in this war, man. So, obviously, most of these men are going to need to leave, except we need to do it this way. I want to leave behind one cannon. Siege requirement is 15, so we need to leave behind one cannon and 15 infantry. That are at full strength. The leader's actually going to leave to get this army off of that province where we're suffering attrition. And then this tiny army is going to come in with a six siege pip leader to help restore that. He'll arrive in 4 days. Here, I don't want the next tick to actually happen yet, so let's just 1, 2. 1, 2. I want to force that army to get there in time so we have the 6 siege pip guy. Didn't actually succeed. Okay, my other armies. Are working on getting down here, but it's going to take some time. This is an actual level 3 fort, so we do have no ability to get through here. We need 9 troops here. Leave 10. Don't let me forget that I've got this, this loan to pay off. 38 war score. Shervin's really not liking this war. Unsurprisingly. And that does it. Okay, so with 40 war score, we can take humiliate and war ups. He has up to 1175 ducats if we want to go another 12 war score. I don't really want to, though. On the other hand, let me just check one thing. How much debt does he have right now? 2 loans. If I make him take out one more loan, he'll be at 3 loans. I'm assuming that, even with luck, it's going to cost him quite a bit to crawl out of that hole. But why does it matter? Let's just, no, I don't care. We're done with the war. All I want is the damn power projection, so whatever. Alright, and that being said, we are at 95% integration on Smolensk. We picked up no aggressive expansion in that war. We isolated. Crap. Wasn't I supposed to break an alliance or something? No, I didn't. Okay, the French already broke the alliance. I think they were allied to the French. I don't remember. Doesn't matter. Remove Oldenburg from the map. While tempting, he is in the coalition. So you want me to attack the coalition head on, huh? It's a lot of work. Brandenburg still thinks that they're too special to be my subject because they've got too much development. It's just silly artificial restriction. But the only person that doesn't like him is these little tiny guys that I can't really do anything about. So I can't see a way to weaken him. Aside from just straight up breaking the alliance. We have 15 favors, 85 trust, like... I guess we just hang out, you know, let him form Prussia and he'll just have to be an ally instead of a subject. It's not really going to affect my ability to get the actual goal, which is 500 ducats of monthly income. We're at 200 out of 500, so about 40% of the way there. However, if we look at Great Britain's income right now, they make another 90, so we're actually like three fifths of the way there. But it should be even higher after we integrate him because trade... Our ability to steer trade is going to get much, much better soon. Port maintenance, 29 ducats a month. 98.3 army tradition. We lost a claim on Lubeck. I still have a claim, don't I? I have no claims on Lubeck now. Less than ideal. Okay, when can we start the integration of Great Britain? We do it right now. Missed my timing. I knew I was getting distracted by that damn war with the Ottomans. So, what are our chances to actually inherit him? -49%. So you're saying I'm gonna have to integrate him, huh? 5 per month. Total cost is how much? It doesn't actually tell me. Cool. So if I were to annex him, the tooltip would tell me exactly the exact cost. But with this, I have to guess. Well, the next idea group we're going to do is administrative. We're going to take administrative ideas. By the time we actually get the integration complete, we will definitely have some administrative efficiency. It's going to take more than 5 years for sure. He's got a lot of development. We already have one of our national ideas reducing integration cost right here. Question is, if I start the integration now, can we finish administrative ideas before he gets integrated, so that we can turn on the policy and save the monarch points? The answer is maybe. It really depends on his cost. It'd be great if it would tell me what his cost is. So, anyway, let's just queue up a shadow diplomat to integrate this fella. And the cost is 3,327 points. So, 1660. Yeah, I think in 50 years we could probably finish that idea group. This is a pretty good chance. Right, that it's not going to be 50 years because of the policy, and also the fact that administrative efficiency is going to lower the cost as well. But yes, we should integrate him. If there's no chance whatsoever to inherit him, then I have to integrate him. Size of country, 61%. Minus 61%. So you're saying it's unlikely. Gotcha. Well, I could just take the vassalized Mecklenburg mission, but he's got a truce with me. Alright, so I need 1172 ducats. I think we can do speed 4. Main thing I need is just time. Like, if I do nothing at all, we'll probably end up making 500 ducats a month. Just because. Because trade's gonna go up, you know? Development across the entire world will go up. We'll build more boats. Boats get better. Trade power propagates, etc. 214 light ships out of a naval supply of 236. We have 60 transports. Might be a few too many, but I think I'll just keep them for now. Could mothball them. Annex subjects is also going to slow down the integration of Great Britain by a fair bit for a while. We have Swedish separatists that are pretty high in Kainu. Mostly due to the conversion. Stockholm as well. They are mostly upset about what? Religious unity, a little bit of intolerance, some separatism. Head up to Narc with somebody. Suffering attrition for no reason is fun. Here's the army we integrated. No mercs in there, right? Okay, and any cav? Nope. No cav. Perfect. Got forts that he wasn't maintaining. We've got forts that border each other now. I think we get rid of this one in Ryzan. Well, actually, let me check. 1751 divided by 50. We need 35 fully maintained current forts, and we have a grand total of 32, so we don't even have enough forts as is. I guess we hold on to them, because I really want to have 100 army tradition at some point in the near future. I want to roll generals with 100 army tradition. And then this whole region here, we have three states now. We're gonna pick up state slots next tech, so let's just wait on all this stuff for now. Trade dispute against Lithuania. I only have a fort in this region. That's unfortunate, but it's not going to be a big deal. The states demand control of territory. Clergy wants some land. That seems fine. Sure, we can find something for them. So they have no leader. Despite the fact that they are much wider than my army, I think we'll just throw our 666 at them now and try to avoid the extra modifiers and stuff. Now, Swedish separatists, do they get infantry combat ability from Sweden? They do not. They do, however, get our infantry type, the Zihwi, whatever the hell they're called. So we have a major, major advantage. This is one of the reasons why I love combat ability, is that it just makes... It makes rebels so weak. They get your discipline, they get your morale, they get your unit type, but they do not get your combat ability. So... just makes it a lot easier. Take these down to 20 stacks if I can. Not a big fan of this composition though. Do we attack next? Sweden in January of 06. So that's coming up very, very soon. Seeing the real you. A 5-3-1 strong claim Jankowski. Administrative points makes sense. We're going to do administrative ID group next. He's only got 9 monarch points altogether, but that's okay. Or we could get 1,158 ducats. And for 5 years, we lose prestige and legitimacy. Now, I think we take the strong claim. Tarvi. Welcome, Tarvi. Damn. What? It said January. I thought that I just accidentally went through like 2 or 3 months, but it said January. Didn't it? I'm gonna go watch the video. I'm gonna watch like a minute ago. I think I said, when's our next truce coming up? Sweden, in January. And then bam, December the 4th joins the coalition. What the hell? All right, October. So that really means probably July. We should have an army adjacent to Lübeck. Probably a preferably a couple. You move over to there. You, with your 10-10, should head over to, like, here. I don't want to lose stability. I guess we take the loyalty. Genoa wants some dudes. Our dudes are the best dudes. I can see why they would want them. $17.42. It's going to speed up, don't worry. But... it certainly could be faster. Ooh, if you had just 0.1% more, we could get extra ducats from these guys. Alright, burgers, what's it gonna take? I could develop one of your provinces, or we could just give you another. I think we give you one more. Take a look at the trade map mode, see if we can find an estuary that they should have, potentially. I think I've already done this many, many times. I think they already have that stuff. Here, have this one. Then give me some money. Pay off our loan. And we still have a lot of money in the bank now. Regimental camps are nice. And again, we're going to go administrative ideas soon and get low-price mercenaries, which I hear are pretty good. So, leaning towards the manufactories now. Alright, I'm gonna look around a little bit, see if I can find something that makes sense. Next episode, we will see what the plan is, but I'm still kind of annoyed that Sweden was able to join the coalition. Wanted to just keep beating up on him, but whatever. Alright, I'll see you guys next time. Thanks for watching, everyone. See you soon.